Hello Virgo, this is your November forecast. So for the first 9 days of the month, we've got Venus and Mars still in your sign Virgo, joining Jupiter in your first house. So Virgos, this is great for you. This is great for your energy. It's a wonderful time for connecting with people. It's a wonderful time for making a good impression on other people. It's a great time for presenting yourself in a very positive light. And it's also a really good time to be putting energy into yourself and enjoying just who you are and appreciating yourself. You have such a tendency, you know, Virgos, you're such the perfectionist of the zodiac. You've not only a tendency to see faults in others, but much more, you're harsher on yourself very often than is at all necessary. So with these aspects, keep in mind to be gentle with yourself. Venus is in your sign for the first 8 days of the month. Be gentle, be kind. The kinder you are to yourself, the kinder other people can be to you as well. So on the 3rd of November, we've got Mercury going into your third house here, joining the Sun. So the Sun shining its light in this third house, telling you Virgos, it's a great time to network, to get out and about. Of course, you can do it in person or you can do it online. Maybe you want to do some online courses. It's great for learning, for studying, for communications of any kind. And very good for technology, especially with the Mercury energy there. So really good for connecting with people in your community, in your neighborhood. It's also a good time to make short trips. Travel here, travel there. You might be quite busy as well. I think you're going to be quite busy this month as well, Virgos. So on the 11th of the month, we've got a new moon happening in this third house. So new beginnings. You might embark upon a new course of study. You might embark upon starting to teach online, run courses online. It's a great time to start a new strategy for selling products and services. Do it differently. It's a good time for looking at new ways in which you can communicate. Be creative in ways that you can connect with other people. Because Virgo, you're a very intelligent sign. So this brings a lot more of your intelligence out to the forefront here with the ability. Many of you got writing and speaking ability, coaching ability. That's really good with these aspects there for you this month. Now on the 9th of November, Venus went into your second house of money. Well, there could be some good news financially. It could mean that a project you've been working on, something good happens. It could be somebody giving you a compliment, but it's likely to be something nice happening financially. On the 11th of the month, we've got Mars joining Venus in this house of money. So it's energizing your finances. So Mars is telling you, come on now, Virgos, get out there. You can do something very productive. You can do something really good financially. You might have some good news about a financial project, but it's important that you are assertive and you go for something with that Mars energy there. Mars and Venus together means that something can come together really fruitfully for you. And on the 21st of November, we've got Mercury going into your fourth house. And on the 23rd of November, the Sun changes sign, goes into Sag, and also joins Saturn and Mercury in your fourth house. So this is shining a light on your home area. Wherever the Sun goes, it's shining a light on that area. So it's asking, you know, how do you feel about your home, your environment? There could be something nice happening with a family member. It may mean that you move home and you settle into a home. Yes, Saturn is often quite a stabilizing influence. Often there's people say, oh, you know, it's so negative. I don't see Saturn as negative. Yes, sometimes there are lessons to be learned if we've kind of gone a little bit off track. But Saturn here could be very positive in helping you settle somewhere, feel more stable. Feel as though you're not all over the place, but you can have some stability. And it could also help you to maybe have a home office, to work from home, and to have some stability from work at home. And on the 25th of November, we've got a full moon happening right up here in Gemini in your 10th house, and full moon shining a light on this house of career, of work. So it could be that a project finishes well for you, something you've been working on. You may get recognition from your workplace. Equally though, because it's shining a light, it also shines a light maybe on the things that haven't been working so well for you. So maybe it's shining a light in your career and saying, well, maybe I need to change direction of career. Maybe I need to learn some more skills so I'm more marketable. But it's going to shine a light on you questioning everything to do with your career. So we're still in this waning square between Neptune and Saturn. Excuse me, whoopsie daisy. So there's every possibility that a relationship may be dissolving. Yes, it's not boom boom like a Uranus energy where it's over and that's it and I don't want to see you anymore. It's somehow it's a dissolving of a relationship, possibly. Could be a business relationship or some kind of a partnership. But it's just a letting go process. And do remember that when something goes out of your life, I firmly believe one door closes and another door opens with something new and even more interesting. So do keep that in mind. So there you have it, my lovely Virgos. I wish you a great month. Thank you for commenting, sharing, subscribing. And don't forget to check out your 2016 forecasts. Bye for now. Hello Virgo. This is your November forecast. So for the first 9 days of the month, we've got Venus and Mars still in your sign Virgo, joining Jupiter in your first house. So Virgos, this is great for you. This is great for your energy. It's a wonderful time for connecting with people. It's a wonderful time for making a good impression on other people. It's a great time for presenting yourself in a very positive light. And it's also a really good time to be putting energy into yourself and enjoying just who you are and appreciating yourself. You have such a tendency, you know, Virgos, you're such the perfectionist of the zodiac. You've not only a tendency to see faults in others, but much more, you're harsher on yourself very often than is at all necessary. So with these aspects, keep in mind to be gentle with yourself. Venus is in your sign for the first 8 days of the month. Be gentle, be kind. The kinder you are to yourself, the kinder other people can be to you as well. So on the 3rd of November, we've got Mercury going into your third house here, joining the Sun. So the Sun shining its light in this third house, telling you Virgos, it's a great time to network, to get out and about. Of course, you can do it in person or you can do it online. Maybe you want to do some online courses. It's great for learning, for studying, for communications of any kind. And very good for technology, especially with the Mercury energy there. So really good for connecting with people in your community, in your neighborhood. It's also a good time to make short trips. Travel here, travel there. You might be quite busy as well. I think you're going to be quite busy this month as well, Virgos. So on the 11th of the month, we've got a new moon happening in this third house. So new beginnings. You might embark upon a new course of study. You might embark upon starting to teach online, run courses online. It's a great time to start a new strategy for selling products and services. Do it differently. It's a good time for looking at new ways in which you can communicate. Be creative in ways that you can connect with other people. Because Virgo, you're a very intelligent sign. So this brings a lot more of your intelligence out to the forefront here with the ability many of you got, writing and speaking ability, coaching ability. That's really good with these aspects there for you this month. Now on the 9th of November, Venus went into your second house of money. Well, there could be some good news financially. It could mean that a project you've been working on, something good happens. It could be somebody giving you a compliment, but it's likely to be something nice happening financially. On the 11th of the month, we've got Mars joining Venus in this house of money. So it's energizing your finances. So Mars is telling you, come on now, Virgos, get out there. You can do something very productive. You can do something really good financially. You might have some good news about a financial project, but it's important that you are assertive and you go for something with that Mars energy there. Mars and Venus together means that something can come together really fruitfully for you. And on the 21st of November, we've got Mercury going into your fourth house. And on the 23rd of November, the Sun changes sign, goes into Sag, and also joins Saturn and Mercury in your fourth house. So this is shining a light on your home area. Wherever the Sun goes, it's shining a light on that area. So it's asking, you know, how do you feel about your home, your environment? There could be something nice happening with a family member. It may mean that you move home and you settle into a home. Yes, Saturn is often quite a stabilizing influence. Often there's people say, oh, you know, it's so negative. I don't see Saturn as negative. Yes, sometimes there are lessons to be learned if we've kind of gone a little bit off track. But Saturn here could be very positive in helping you settle somewhere, feel more stable. Feel as though you're not all over the place, but you can have some stability. And it could also help you to maybe have a home office, to work from home, and to have some stability from work at home. And on the 25th of November, we've got a full moon happening right up here in Gemini in your 10th house. And full moon shining a light on this house of career, of work. So it could be that a project finishes well for you, something you've been working on. You may get recognition from your workplace. Equally though, because it's shining a light, it also shines a light maybe on the things that haven't been working so well for you. So maybe it's shining a light in your career and saying, well, maybe I need to change direction of career. Maybe I need to learn some more skills so I'm more marketable. But it's going to shine a light on you questioning everything to do with your career. So we're still in this waning square between Neptune and Saturn. Excuse me, whoopsie daisy. So there's every possibility that a relationship may be dissolving. Yes, it's not boom boom like a Uranus energy where it's over and that's it and I don't want to see you anymore. It's somehow it's a dissolving of a relationship, possibly. Could be a business relationship or some kind of a partnership, but it's just a letting go process. And do remember that when something goes out of your life, I firmly believe one door closes and another door opens with something new and even more interesting. So do keep that in mind. So there you have it, my lovely Virgos. I wish you a great month. Thank you for commenting, sharing, subscribing. And don't forget to check out your 2016 forecasts. Bye for now.